Hey guys, welcome back to the Dimcad channel. We're getting closer and closer to the election, so I want you guys to be prepared for anything. Just don't leave yourself vulnerable. We talk about guns, ammo, magazines, and stuff like that, but what about your vehicle? Simple things. I've suggested this on many occasions. This is actually a jump starter. It'll actually start your battery. If your battery dies, this will actually get your vehicle going. I've rescued so many people with just this one device alone. So make sure you're prepared like that. Here's another thing you should have. You should carry with you at all times in your vehicle a portable air compressor. If you got low tire, low whatever, you gotta have something like this available. Maybe somebody will slash your tire, and maybe you might puncture your tire. It might be a nail in your tire. Maybe you might be able to repair it. And then once you do that, how do you actually get air into the actual tire? Something to think about. Some little things you gotta keep in mind. Another thing. Obviously, you want to have the right gear, but part of having the right gear is having boots, having the right type of pants. I mean, you just never know. I've been buying more and more of these 5/11 tactical pants. This one's actually, this is not as, it doesn't have as many pockets as the other ones do, but I like that. Plenty of pockets. It's not like a million pockets like you get with other ones, but just enough to really get by. Another thing, speaking of pockets, right here in this one actually has a lot of different pockets. This right here, recoil spring assembly. Spare parts for your guns. Especially if you have something like a Glock or something, or a polymer pistol, striker fire pistol. You know, if you break one of these things, you don't want to have to wait a week to get another one. I mean, you know, your gun is pretty much inoperable if this breaks. So something to keep in mind. Now, maybe you might have a gun with a steel guide rod. Good for you. You may even want to decide to replace something like this with something that's made of steel. Might be an idea. But keep that in mind. Take some action. All right, politically, Steve Bannon has come out and said that he's basically the orchestrator behind this whole Hunter Biden email situation. And he says that he's gonna have multiple sources release more information very, very soon. I don't know where it's coming from. I've heard a lot of things that I won't repeat on YouTube. Do your own research. But we're gonna find out really, really soon. We're also gonna find out if the American people really care. All right, here's what we know so far. It looks like this hard drive is indicating that Joe Biden has been compromised, ties with Chinese money. There's also implications that it might actually be some illegal activity going on with Hunter Biden. A lot of illegal activity. We're talking about 25,000 photos. I don't know what that is. Again, you guys can look it up, do your own research. And, well, I mean, the FBI, we know the FBI actually knew about this stuff, knew about this hard drive. They didn't do anything. I mean, apparently they had access to this information and they just sat on it, which isn't surprising, but it's a sad state of affairs when you're not surprised by something like that. And I mean, I think it's a big deal to have somebody who's challenging the president, going to be possibly the president of the United States, Joe Biden, and have this person be the type of individual who's compromised. Person who's compromised by China, Russia, whatever, all these different countries. I think it's a big deal. I think it's a big deal to be that corrupt if he's really engaged in this. And the weird thing is, he hasn't come out. Joe Biden hasn't come out and said that this is absolutely false. The emails are fake, this and that. He hasn't really said that. He said something like this is a smear campaign, but he hasn't really spoken a lot about this. So it makes me wonder what's going on. Now the big question is, does the American people actually care? I don't know, but I think you can only ignore so much. We'll find out really soon. Okay, I've been going to the range on a more consistent basis, and I definitely encourage you guys to consider that as well. Some gun news, the ATF, of course, issued a cease and desist order to the company that produces the Honey Badger pistol. Now, this pistol is an AR-15 with a brace, and they were basically told to stop their operations. ATF considered it to be a SBR. They had reason to believe so. Well, as you guys know, is a lot of people have been talking about this on the internet, on social media, and now The ATF has reversed their decision, well, at least temporarily. They issued a 60-day suspension of their honey badger decision. So for 60 days, they suspended their cease and desist order. Now, this doesn't mean that the whole situation is going away. Not at all. It just means that they're maybe they were a little surprised. Maybe there were some rogue elements within the ATF that were a little, they were trying to perhaps damage Trump, hurt Trump in his election. I'm not sure. I don't know that, but I do know that there's been some type of reversal. I do know that Trump better get this situation under control.
Channel, I'm out here to shoot my AK-45. I can't go too long without shooting it, or else, you know, I just gotta really be disciplined with the grip to avoid any type of errors, but something to keep in mind. You cock it, double action first. Next gun I definitely won't have this issue with. Oh. Ah.